The frustration just mounts when I even, if anybody mentions a birth certificate anymore, I just, I want to go off on them.
And what trouble she's had. This is this Southern Indiana woman who's facing the reality that she may have been celebrating the wrong birthday for 74 years. Well, getting the date changed on your birth certificate is no easy task. With Real ID being enforced all across the country next May, it might be wise to get your documents in order. Travis Breeze found a possible solution to one woman's nightmare and what you need for Real ID.
Everything that I've done for 74 years has got August 27th on it.
Carolyn in North Clark County is drowning in documents.
I'm just getting cramps in my hands for no reason at all.
We're not using her last name because we're using her full birthday, August 27th, 1948, right?
I know Ron, my husband, made comments, well, you don't know whether celebrate on the 26th or 27th.
Carolyn and Ron tried to go on an Alaskan cruise 4 years ago. In order to go, she needed a passport. And to get that, she needed a copy of her birth certificate. That's when she got a shock.
So I immediately says, I'm sorry, you've made a mistake here. And the lady told me that they hadn't made a mistake. She said that's what was in our basement in our permanent records.
There is a discrepancy between Carolyn's real birth certificate housed at the Department of Vital Statistics and what's called the souvenir, the one her mom was given the night she was born. Her whole life, Carolyn has used August 27th, and she did not know up until a few years ago that the document in her possession was unofficial.
I can't believe that a mother would not remember her child's birth date.
When we told Norton Healthcare about the situation, a spokesperson said, with the incident in question happening 74 years ago, we are unable to say how the discrepancy occurred. We file birth information with the state after it has been verified with the birth parent. The birth information filed with the state remains the source of truth for vital information. The issue is coming to a head right now because all states will require a Real ID to fly and enter federal buildings in May.
I'd like to have it no matter what.
Vital Statistics declined an interview for this story, but told us a court order is needed to change a birth certificate, unless you can prove the person filing the original document made a mistake.
The only way that I know to handle it is to file suit.
The Legal Aid Society suggested Carolyn sue Vital Statistics using the souvenir document as proof. They say the more documents, the better, but the department is usually willing to make an amendment.
You tell them, I've just filed this lawsuit. Here's the evidence.
Carolyn is considering going to court, but for now, she may just have to celebrate two birthdays.
I just wish they would have something in place to correct it.
She'll have to work at this a little bit longer if she wants to go on that Alaskan cruise.
I just feel like going, I should have had a V8.
You don't have to have a Real ID, but if you plan on flying or entering a government building, these are the five groups of documents you're going to need. You'll need proof of identity other than your current license, proof of name change, which could be marriage licenses, and also your citizenship status. If it's not your first document, it would be a foreign passport with your visa forms. You'll need proof of Social Security, also two proofs of residency, which is likely things that you got in the mail. You got to have your Real ID by May 3rd of next year. In the studio, Travis Breeze, WHAS 11 on your side.